Good afternoon, students. Today our topic is compensator. Sometimes it is necessary to compensate an unstable system to make it stable, or it may be necessary to improve the existing system to satisfy or to meet the required specification. Most requirement or main requirement of control system is accuracy and stability. For greater stability or for greater accuracy of system, steady state error should be small, because steady state error is inversely proportional to the gain. So we can reduce steady state error by increasing the gain of amplifier. But when we increase gain of the amplifier, overshoot will increase means there will be more oscillation in the system, and it means that stability will decrease. But we are interested in both accuracy and stability. So this can be done by connecting a circuit between error detector and a plant, and this circuit is known as compensating circuit. Discussing compensator, first we clarify what is the difference between controller and compensator. Controller is a device that forces the output towards a certain direction in order to reduce the error. It means the objective of controller is to respond to the error, while the objective of compensator is to change the original dynamics of system. Original dynamics of system means to change the parameters of system by adding poles or zeros to the system and make corrections in the output. So we can say that we can define a compensator as a device which is used to improve performance specifications such as steady state or transient response by adding pole and zero to the system, or by changing the parameter of system. So both lead and lag compensator add one zero and one pole to the system to get the desired specification, performance specification. Suppose that transfer function of a system is given by Gs is equal to K by S, S plus 1, S plus 2. It is required that velocity constant Kv corresponding to a steady state error should be 10. We know that Kv is given by limit S approaches 0. As Gs. So substitute the value of Gs, we get the value of Kv is equal to K by 2, because S is 0, S is 0, S is 0. So value of Kv is equal to K by 2, and value of Kv is given by 10. So if we substitute the value of Kv, then we get the value of system gain. K is equal to 20. And we put the value of K, so we get the value of Gs is equal to 20 divided by S, S plus 1 multiplied by S plus 2. Then we can calculate the characteristic equation, and characteristic equation is given by 1 plus GSHS is equal to 0. Here we substitute the value of K GSHS. 1 plus GSHS is equal to K divided by S, S plus 1, S plus 2, and value of HS is 1. This is unity feedback system. So we get S cube plus 2S square plus 2S plus K is equal to 0. This is the characteristic equation of given system. So we form a Routh Hurwitz array, and from this array we know that for a stable system, this 6 minus K divided by 3 must be greater than 0, because this quantity and this term both are greater than 0. So there is no change in the first column, and system should be, in that case, system should be stable. Will be stable. And if 6 minus k divided by 3 is greater than 0, it means that k should be less than 6. In case of accuracy, value of k should be 20, and for system to be stable, value of k should be less than 6. So we can say that accuracy and stability cannot meet in this time. So a compensating system is used. Types of compensation. Depending upon location of compensating network, following types of compensation. Series compensation. When a compensating network is inserted. Hello. Hello. When a compensating network is inserted, Avantika. Quick problem. Okay. When a compensating network is inserted in a forward path, in this circuit, this compensating network is inserted in forward path, then this is known as series or cascade compensator. If compensating network is inserted in feedback path, then it is known as feedback compensator. And if compensator circuit is added in forward path and in feedback path, then it is known as load compensator. The compensator may be electrical, mechanical, pneumatic, or hydraulic. Mostly electrical networks are used. It is easy to design RC filter. So for the design of compensator network, mainly transfer function approach is used. This is a circuit diagram of lead compensator. Here I is equal to I1 plus I2. I is equal to I1 plus I2. I1 is equal to E1 minus E2 divided by R1. Similarly, I2 is equal to C d by dt multiplied by E1 minus E2. So if we substitute the value of I1 and I2 in this equation, we get I is equal to E1 minus E2 divided by R1 plus C d by dt E1 minus E2. And I3 is equal to E2 divided by R2. And if we substitute the value of I3, we get this equation. Taking Laplace transform of this equation, we get E2 by E1 is equal to R2 plus R1 R2 C into S divided by R1 plus R2 plus R1 R2 C. Then taking R1 R2 divided by R1 by R2 common, and value of put R1 plus R2 divided by R2 is equal to A. So value of A is greater than 1. And T is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 C. Then we write E2 by E1 is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Here we take, we write this equation 1 plus R1 Cs like this and substitute the value of A and T in this equation. So we get E2 by E1 is equal to 1 by A, 1 plus A T S divided by 1 plus T S. This is the transfer function of lead compensator. Lead compensator act as an high frequency First we plot the pole zero plot of transfer function of lead compensator. Zero is at, in this transfer function, zero is equal to 1 minus 1 by AT, and pole is at 1 by minus 1 by T. So when we plot pole zero, plot for transfer function of lead compensator, we get a plot like this, and zero is nearer to this imaginary axis as compared to the pole. So this zero acts as a dominant pole, and since zero provides positive phase shift, this compensator network provides positive phase shift, or phase shift is increased in this compensator. So it is known as phase lead compensator circuit. Phase lead compensator circuit allow to pass high frequency and low frequencies are attenuated. E2 by E1, this is a transfer function of given phase lead compensator. For high frequency, omega tends to infinite. Then we write E2 by E1 is equal to 1 by A, 1 by S plus AT, and 1 by S divided by 1 by S plus T. If we substitute S, S is equal to J omega. So if we substitute omega is equal to infinite, this equation is converted into E2 by E1 is equal to 1. Means in this case, when frequency is high, output is equal to the input, means all the high frequency signals are passed by lead compensator, so it acts as an high pass filter. Similarly, for low, for low frequency, when omega tends to zero, equation is converted into E2 by E1 is equal to 1 by A, and since A is greater than 1, E2 is greater than, means E1 is greater than E2, means input is greater than output, it means that output is attenuated. So low frequency signals are stopped by lead compensator. Both plot of phase lead network. Transfer function A multiplied by E2 divided by E1. Magnitude of this is equal to 1 plus ATS divided by 1 plus TS. It means that there is no pole or no zeros at the origin. And if we take, so, and value of K is 1. So initial slope of both plot is 20 log k, value of k is 1, it means that we get 0 dB slope at the starting, and this is the starting of both plot for this transfer function. Then this is the corner frequency 1 by AT. This is a corner frequency, and at this corner frequency, 0 is activated, and for since 0 is activated, there is a slope of plus 20 dB per decade. So next corner frequency is 1 by T, and at this frequency, pole is activated. Since pole is activated at this frequency, this slope plus 20 dB per decade is cancelled by minus 20 dB per decade, and we get a zero slope of this line, 20 dB log A. This is the magnitude plot, and this is the phase plot of Bode plot. For phase plot, if A is greater than 1, since A is greater than 1, A omega t is greater than omega t, and tan inverse A omega t is greater than tan inverse omega t. Clear? And if we calculate the phase angle of A multiplied by E2 divided by E1, then phase angle psi is equal to tan inverse imaginary part divided by real part, tan inverse A T omega minus tan inverse omega T. This is greater than this, means this term is greater than this term. It means that psi is positive for all values of omega. And if we substitute, omega is 0 here, omega is 0 here, phase angle is 0, and if we substitute omega is infinite, then we get 0 degree. Here, when omega is 0, phase angle is 0, when omega tends to infinity, phase angle is 0, psi is always positive, so it acquires a maximum value at certain value of omega m. We have to calculate the maximum value of psi or phase angle. So we calculate, so we differentiate psi with respect to omega. If we differentiate psi with respect to omega, we get this equation, and next we get second equation, and if we simplify this equation, we get this equation, and by simplifying we get the value of omega m, the frequency at which phase angle is maximum, and this is given by under root a 1 by under root a multiplied by t, or this can be written as under root 1 by t multiplied by 1 by a t or alpha t. 1 by t is corner frequency, this is also corner frequency. It means that omega m is geometrical mean of two corner frequency. Clear? Omega 1 is 1 by t and omega 2 is 1 by alpha. It means that omega m is the geometrical mean of two corner frequencies. Now we will take 5 minutes break, and then we will continue the class after 5 minutes. Okay. Shubham. Now we will take 5 minute break.
हेलो,
we calculated the value of omega m. So maximum phase lead occurs at frequency of omega m, and omega value of omega m is given by 1 by under root a multiplied by t. Put the value of omega m in psi m. If you substitute the value of omega m, you get the value of 10 psi m, and from 10 psi m we calculate the value of sine psi m, which is given by this, and from this equation we calculate the value of a. A is attenuation factor. Then design procedure for phase lead compensator. First, we plot magnitude and phase versus frequency curve for GS of uncompensated or original system. Then calculate the phase margin of from Bode plot. First, we draw the Bode plot for uncompensated system, magnitude and phase plot. Then from that graph, Bode plot, we calculate the phase margin of uncompensated system. Psi is specified phase margin, and this is margin of stability. So we calculate the maximum value of psi m, or maximum value of phase angle, which is given by psi s minus psi plus the margin of safety. And if psi m is greater than 60, two identical networks, each contributing maximum lead of psi m by 2, are used. Then in next step we calculate the value of a, which is given, which is calculated by value of psi m, from the value of psi m. Then calculate the value of omega m, determine the value of a. All the steps are clear in the following example. Design a cascade compensation for a system whose transfer function is given by this. It will fulfill the following specification: phase margin should be greater or equal to 45, and velocity constant kv is equal to 1100 per second. Kv is given by limit s multiplied by gs, where s approaches 0. And in this case, when s approaches 0, we get kv is equal to k. Since kv, value of kv is 1000, value of k is also 1000, and this is the transfer function. First, we have to plot the Bode, the magnitude and phase plot of this transfer function. There are two corner frequencies corresponding to this term. 10 radians per second, this is first corner frequency corresponding to this term. Next corner frequency is 1000 radians per second. And if we calculate the phase angle of partial function gs, it is given by when omega is 1. Resultant phase angle is given by minus 95.7. Similarly, when value of value of omega is 5, resultant phase angle is this. For different values of omega, corresponding phase angle is given in this table. So we draw phase angle, phase plot from these readings. And for magnitude plot, first we draw the Bode plot. This is a transfer function of uncompensated system. Gs is given by 1000 divided by s multiplied by s plus 0.1s multiplied by 1 plus 0.001. This is the transfer function of uncompensated system. Means there is no compensating technique is used in this system. So first we draw the Bode plot for this. Magnitude plot, there is one pole at origin. It means that an value of k is 1000. It means that we start, this is omega, value of omega, here value of omega is 1000, and from this point we draw a line of slope of minus 20 dB per decade due to presence of one pole at origin. Omega, value of omega is 1000, and this line is of slope of minus 20 dB per decade, and this line cuts y axis at this point, and this is the starting point of Bode plot. Next, first corner frequency is 10 omega, 10 radian per second. So this is the frequency. Here, this is the frequency of value of frequency is 1000, and this is the value of frequency where omega, value of omega is 10. And this is the corner frequency, and at this frequency, this pole is activated, so slope becomes minus 40 dB due to second pole is activated at this frequency, and the third corner frequency is 1000. So this is the second corner frequency is 1000. So, and from this frequency, next pole is activated, so the slope becomes minus 60 dB per decade, and this is the magnitude Bode plot of uncompensated system. This is the phase plot of uncompensated system of Bode plot, and this is gain crossover frequency. Corresponding to this gain crossover frequency, we get the same phase crossover frequency. It means that gain margin is 0, phase margin is 0. So from uncompensated Bode plot, we get 0 phase margin. Thank you. First step, draw the magnitude and phase plot of uncompensated system. Then calculate the phase margin. Phase margin is zero in that case. And in given question, specified phase margin is 45. Margin of safety is 5. So we get the maximum value of phase is 45 minus 0 plus 5. It means maximum phase angle is 50 degree. We get the value of psi m by calculating the value of psi m, we get the value of a. If we put the value of psi m 50, we get the value of a, which is equal to 7.51. Then the magnitude contribution of compensating network at omega m is given by, after calculating the value of a, then we calculate the value of omega m, which is calculated by this procedure. The magnitude contribution of compensating network at omega m is given by minus 10 log a. Substitute the value of a, we get minus 8.75 dB. Here you see that at omega m, value of magnitude at this point is minus 10 dB per decade, or the value of this is 20 log a, or at this point we get 10 log a. Value of magnitude of Bode plot at this point at omega is equal to omega m, maximum value of omega m, value of magnitude plot is 10 log a. Zero, ये है the magnitude contribution of compensating network at omega m is given by minus 10 log a, and if we substitute the value of a, we get minus 8.75, and from this graph, if we calculate the value of omega m corresponding to minus 8.75, this is the value of omega m, and this value of omega m is given by, this is 170. Okay, time is over. Next class I will tell you all about this.